So recently I made a video about CF Spark, this one right here. It's Creative Fabrica's AI system, and there are so many things on there. But in this video, I wanted to do a tutorial on how you can use some of those designs that you make on CF Spark and combine them with fonts that you can get for free on Creative Fabrica and put them all together to make a t-shirt design like this. I'm gonna do all of this in Affinity Designer. Of course, you can use your own graphics app. You can do Photopea or Adobe products or whatever. I'm gonna show you exactly how to do it so you can follow along. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I wanted to do a t-shirt design tutorial using designs from CF Spark. So I'm gonna use some of the AI designs on there as well as some free fonts on there on Creative Fabrica. Now, there's lots of different things on Creative Fabrica. You can download designs and other things. I'm gonna kinda keep it pretty specific. Now, I can do other tutorials, but this one's gonna be specific to the AI part of it, and I'll show you how to do it, how to download, and how big it is, and try and answer all your questions. So let's get into CF Spark or Creative Fabrica's website first, and I'll show you the things that I'm gonna download. All right, so here we are on creativefabrica.com. You may have come here before. The part we're gonna go into is Spark. Now, I've had a video, like I said, about these. I went over all of these. The one that I think is the easiest to use is the transparent PNG. So let's go there, create transparent PNG. And you're gonna see that I made some here already with some frogs. I did some butterflies, I did some mushrooms, and here's the prompts right here. So I did 3 mushrooms with red and white tops. I did origin 2D V2, right? So that's this right here. So if you wanna try it, every time you do it, it's gonna be different. Yours may not look exactly the same like this, but it will be similar. The nice thing about this, about AI, is that you're gonna have different graphics. So there's no one that's gonna have the exact same thing. So that's really helped with copyright protection and things like that, right? So you're gonna do yours. One thing you can do, so let's see if you find one that you like. I'm gonna download this one. You can see I've already published it. So if I like this one, you come here and you hit publish, and this one has been published. So I'm gonna open it so you can see what happens. And so I'm gonna use these mushrooms here, and I'm just gonna download it. Well, I already downloaded, but I'm gonna, that's what you do. You just hit download and it'll download to your file. And I'll show you how big it is. So you can see it's definitely big enough. I already tested it, but I'm gonna download more than one thing. So I'm gonna do, I'll go back here and show you. I'm gonna do this mushroom. I'm gonna take some of these butterflies. I like this one right here. Take a bunch of these butterflies. And then I'm thinking about putting a frog in there too. So I'm gonna do a whole mashup of different things. And that you can do because you have so many credits. I had like 1900 credits. And so you can keep trying different things. If you don't like the shape of that frog or this frog, you know, try a different frog. But the nice thing is try it in all the same model. So you can see I did origin 2D V2 for all of them. So they kind of match together so they can work together, right? I also did this one down here, which is a different kinds of thing. I really like this one, how it came out. And this one is 3D V2. You can see I use that as well as this butterfly here. So this is 3D V2. So I could mash this one up with this one, and I'll show you that later too. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna download these 3 things, this mushroom, the butterfly, and the frog. And I'm gonna open it up in Affinity Designer. They're PNGs, but they're transparent PNGs, and they're big enough so I can scale them down. I can't scale them up, but I can scale them down and they'll still be fine. I'll show you how big they are in Affinity Designer, and you'll see what I do from there. Next thing, before I leave Creative Fabrica, I'm gonna need a font. So let's go to freebies, all freebies. And you can see there's a bunch of cool freebies here. And the nice thing about this is it always includes commercial license, right? So you can use these on print on demand. I'm gonna do actually fonts, and I'll show you how to download these too. So I'm gonna go, I think I saw it on page 3. Now some pretty cool ones. I want something like this here. So I'm gonna do sugar peachy font. And you can see, I love how it's kind of vintage and we're gonna do the layers like that. I'm gonna try and copy that. So I'm gonna download this as well. I'll show you how to upload a font if you're on a Mac. Sorry for those that are on PC, but it's pretty easy to do on a Mac. So if you're on a Mac, you're gonna have to open your font book application, and maybe in your applications folder. If you're like me, it's down below. I put it with all my other stuff because I use fonts a lot. Just open that up and I'll show you what to do next. So here I have font book open. The thing you're gonna wanna do is to go to file and then hit add fonts to current user. So I'm the current user. I'm gonna hit that, or you could hit command O for open, right? I'm gonna do that. And then it's just gonna open my folder here. So if this isn't your folder that you found, you can go back and, you know, maybe it's in your downloads folder that you just downloaded. You can see super peachy. Select all of these like this and then hit open, and then it's gonna load it onto your font. Super easy. You can see mine is already there. If I do sugar peachy and I click on it, you can see I have a bunch of them here, and it's all loaded. I have 10 styles here. So that's how easy it is to load a font from Creative Fabrica. So let's get into Affinity Designer and I'll show you how to create this design. So here I am in Affinity Designer. I made an artboard here that is 4500 by 5400. If you're in any other graphic design app, Photopea or Adobe or whatever, just make sure you have the artboard at that size, right? So now I'm gonna just drag in the elements. They come in your downloads folder. When you download it, it's gonna be in a zip file. Double click that zip file, and then it's gonna open that transparent PNG. So let's see what I got here. I'm gonna drag this one in. You can see the frog is pretty big. I don't wanna make it any bigger. I can make it smaller, but I'm gonna put it on the side here. Here's the butterflies. We're gonna use those. Move that off the screen. And the mushrooms. All right, great. So you can see they're pretty big size. They're not exactly 4,500 wide, but I think they're big enough. I just have to remember not to size them up too much. So the nice thing about this is they're all together. So I'm gonna separate them out by using the crop tool here. So I'll show you what I mean. I'm just gonna crop this and crop this down like that. There's one mushroom. I'm gonna do that again. I'm gonna hold option and drag this here, and I'm gonna use the crop again and kind of get the other one. So let's see, maybe I want this one. That's almost good. I might not use that one. Let me try again with the bigger one. I wanna make sure I got that big one here. That one's good. And let's see, just gonna crop it in right there. Good. Cool. And let's see if I can get that other one. I'm gonna crop that out here. There's this one. Cool, so the nice thing about these is now that they're cropped, I can put them like by each other. So, no, that one's in front. This one's in back, and you got this big one here, right? Cool, and now I can take the frog and kind of put him in the front. Now I can make him smaller. That's pretty cool, like that. And then I got these butterflies. I'm gonna do the same thing with the butterflies. I'm gonna crop them out. So I'm gonna make another one here. Use the crop tool again. You can see that my design is gonna be so original from the other ones that, you know, nobody's gonna have the same exact design as I am. So I'm gonna put that here. Now, you can see I can't exactly crop this one. Whoops. You can see I can't exactly crop this one because this butterfly is right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna crop it a different way. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a shape around here and just have that butterfly. So I'll show you what I mean. I'll put a pen tool here and then just draw a shape around it. Boom. Now I'm gonna take off the stroke. It's just that shape here. And if I go to layers, you'll see if I do both of these and move it to the front, there's the butterfly and then there's that shape that I made. So if I just grab the butterfly and bring it into the shape like that, you can see it cuts it off. So I can use this now like that, and this will go over there. And let's use another butterfly. So I wanna use, I can do the same thing for all of these. So I wanna use that one right there. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna draw around it. right? It can be whatever you want. Take both of these, move them out the front. You can see, take that again, move it into here. Boom, it's cropped. Now I can change it and move it around. Great, right? So the next thing I wanna do is maybe put some fonts here. So you can see all of this is still transparent though. So let me show you, look, I can make the t-shirt whatever color I want in the back and it is transparent. So it will work on different colors. So the next thing I wanna do is put that font. I'm gonna just use the words be wild just so you can see the different words here. I'm gonna click on text. I'm gonna do be wild. Now that font should be in our library here. Remember it was called sugar peachy. That's right, sugar peachy. And by default it's medium, but I can go black here, which is really dark. And I can go do the white outline. We'll do white right here. And it had an outline on it on some of them. So I'm gonna do a black outline. Boom. And give it a stroke. Great. And so we're gonna use some of the glyphs on here. So it had some really cool glyphs. We highlight the E and go to the glyphs right here. And you can go all the way down and see how you can see some of these. I'm gonna click this E. I'm gonna click, there's an L down here. Let's do that, this L, or maybe this L. I think that one's cooler. And then there's a D over here. Let's try that D. Cool. All right, and you can, if you need more space, you can hit Option and move it like that. Or if you wanna use a different one, let's do one that's just the bottom. There we go. That way it's better. All right. Now remember there was the different layers to this, right? So I'm gonna do different layers to this. So all I have to do is hit Command J. And you can see it's below it. Pick the one below it and I'll do like, I'll hold down Shift and hit down 3 times. 1, 2, 3, maybe 6 times. 1, 2, 3. And 6 to the left or right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 there. And then I can just color the inside and come here to the color. Maybe pick one of these colors. I don't know. Green is kind of cool, or purple. Let's do this light purple. Boom. Isn't that cool? Now you can move both of these to the back if you want. And I think that would be cool. Let's add some more color. So let's. There's the bottom one here. Again, hit Command J, do the bottom, Shift and click down arrow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the right. And then, you know, pick another color that's in here, maybe that red. Isn't that neat? And there you go. Those are some, that's a cool t-shirt there. I'm gonna move the frog a little bit. Now you can play around with this. Move things around. Maybe you want the butterfly there instead, or this closer like that. Maybe you want this here so you can see that. See, everything can be moved and it's on its own there. All right. So there you go, pretty easy. I'm gonna show you what I did with some other ones. I played around with it and did some other designs with the 3D one, and so I'll come back and show you all of them together. So I made a few more designs with that font and different graphics from Creative Fabrica, the Spark, right? So these are the cartoony ones, but check out this 3D one. Well, I did this one here, you know, kind of doing that sandwich idea. You can see I can move things around, right? So if I wanted to go here or here, that's great. And then I did this one. I really like this one, how this turned out. Look at this 3D mushroom and the butterflies. I did just a lot more realistic, and I think this can stand out. And again, using the same font but with that different colors to match here. And I really like this one too. You can see I can move this around. I did the same kind of thing, clipping it out, so you know I can move it here if I like that there, or if I want this right here. I can do that as well. So lots of ways that you can do this. And I love it because it's transparent PNG, so I can move things around and it comes in about the right size. You may have to scale it up a little bit, but that's not gonna harm it too much because we're not scaling it up from like 1,000 to 4,000. It's already coming in at about, what is it? That 4,096 is the biggest it gets. So 4,096 to 4,500, not a huge scale up. So I would say try not to scale it up if you don't have to, but if you need to scale it up just a little bit, it won't be too bad. So look at that, pretty cool how it comes out. And I'm gonna put this one on a t-shirt right here and I'll show you what it looks like on a t-shirt. You can see it right there. Looks pretty good, I really like it. And again, these are all your own graphics you made in CF Spark. So nobody will have these same graphics. You don't have to worry about, you know, buying graphics and then somebody else buying the same graphics. You're gonna have your own type of mushroom, your own type of, well, the butterfly may look similar because butterflies all look similar, but your mushrooms are gonna look different and whatever you design, right? If you make a cat or a unicorn or whatever, they're gonna be their own thing. So I think this is a really cool idea with AI because you can make stuff and you can try it over and over again until you find the right style that you want, and then it's yours, and you can remove it from Creative Fabrica after you download it so nobody else uses it if you don't want to share. And I think it turns out great. This is a really cool style right here. You may have to try things over and over to get the right one, but you'll have a lot of credits there. So there you go, a full tutorial on how to use some of the designs that transparent PNG from CF Spark, as well as uploading your own fonts and using your own fonts from their free fonts. There's lots to do on Creative Fabrica. Let me know in the comments if you want me to do another tutorial from Creative Fabrica, different things on there. I'd love to show you how it works. Thanks again for watching. And if you wanna see that first tutorial video of CF Spark, I have it right here. I go through all the different ones. If you haven't seen that already, maybe this will be a good one to brush up on and see all the different styles you can do with AI. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.